I do find myself wanting to do more, I almost want to say emo bitchy looks.
Darkness reigns, here I come, hear me roar.
Well, hello my lovely nestlings and welcome to today's video where I'm going to chat about eyeshadow palettes, specifically the 10 eyeshadow palettes that I have in my collection that make me think of autumn or fall or herfst, as we say in Dutch. And if you are new, welcome. My name is Nikki. I'm 45 from the Netherlands, hence the accent. And if you love makeup just as much as I do, if you want to learn how to be fabulous in your 40s, or maybe you already are fabulous like me, if you want to be entertained, if you want to be inspired by unusual color combinations, and if you are slightly orcish, then this is the channel for you. Subscribe now, become part of my nestlings, because we are having a blast here on the internet. Yes, the slightly orcish is the hashtag that I'm kind of throwing out there. It means olive. So if you are an olive, you are part of my tribe. We need to start a Halloween-y band with my other tribe, because to every Shrek, we need a Fiona, right? You are all welcome here. You all have a place in my tribe. We are all going to start a Halloween-y band and you can play any instrument that you want to. Yes, I have quite a big, I have quite a substantial collection and there are more palettes that I could pull for this video, but I just pulled 10 that really give me autumn-y vibes. And what do I mean with autumn-y vibes? I just find myself being drawn to specific colors when we are in specific weather conditions. That's me though, and because it's my channel and my video, I'm going to talk about what I want to put on my eyeballs this time of year. I think I have two repeats from last year, but for the rest it's all newer palettes, because I kind of want to give you options. The palettes that are in this video are only palettes that I have played with. Yes, go watch your last year's video as well, because it's, yeah, you should. Why? Because I say so. I don't know. Let's just get into the video. Let's start with the two palettes that were also in last year's video, because they are just the two palettes that I have in my collection that if you say to me, grab your autumn palettes, these are the first two that I grab. So the first one is from 5050 Makeup. It's the autumn palette. I got this one in PR. This is just my grungy, autumn-y palette. It could also kind of go a little bit more towards the end of fall, early winter. It could also go around Halloween-y time, but this is just such a yummy, gorgeous, grungy color story. I think it's still available. I will list it down below. I know that a lot of you who were with me last year have bought this on my recommendation and you love it. Honestly, yeah, I still really, really love this. She chose just so well. This shade here, the shade Decay, it makes me think of Death and Decay, and I love it. I have said that before. It's one of these. Can you see it? The teal to brown. I love shades like that. And the quality is very, 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 very nice. This is just, before I got more neutrals in my collection, this was basically my neutral palette. Yes. Let's next go to the next palette that is basically the autumn palette in my collection. The reason that it is also still in this video is because they kind of re-released it in another formula. As I'm filming this, I haven't ordered the replacement yet, but I am going to, just so you know. I don't really know when this video is going online, but just so you know, I either have it already in-house, the palette that I'm going to show you now, the reformulated one, maybe you know then what I'm talking about. It's the Ace Beauté Classical Paradise palette. This, for me, it's just an autumn palette. Now, this is the old formula, that or the original formula that I have. As I said, they just re-released all their older palettes with their new formula. I'm going to order it as I'm filming this, because there were quite a lot of you who said that you wanted to know how it compared. So I am going to, maybe I already have it in-house. Hell, maybe even the video is already online. I don't know yet. I'm kind of pre-filming because I really, really like the look that I have on my face today. Yes, this is just such a, this color. Oh, and then this one, the shade Mineral. I think this is actually my favorite shade in this entire palette. So usually if I grab this palette, I'm going to play with Golden Apple, with Maze, and then with Mineral. just because this is just such a, it's so, so complementary to my skin tone. Also, I know that there are a lot of olives in the spectrum. I am a warm, delicate olive. So basically the shade golden apple that you see here, it's a hint too warm for me maybe, but it's almost the perfect neutral. Because yeah, that's, I'm an olive-y, what can I say? The next palette is a palette that is the newest to my collection as I am filming this. I'm also in the process of filming multiple looks with it. This is actually look number 4 and I really liked it. So I was like, I'm going to film this video now because I want to feature this look again. And it is from Nomad Cosmetics. It's their Haunted Europe. And can we just appreciate that? Now this can kind of go around Halloween-y as well, just because of the theme. But this, for me, and then especially this part, it's just autumn. And then the part that you have here, so the more, the cooler toned part, is more, I don't know, maybe end of autumn, early winter, Halloween-y. So this is, as I said, one of the looks that I'm doing with this palette. You can go from very soft, yes, 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 there is one soft look, I know who am I, in the video. It's Nikki style though, still, but still, it's... You can go colorful, you can go, I don't know, monochromatic a little bit, you can go a little bit more full and warm and then cool here. Yeah, I really, really like this palette. You can go, I don't know, the next look that I am going to film is here, because I really want to play here. I think that will be very, very pretty. Yeah, I just, yeah, what can I say? I think it's a very, very nice fall palette that is neutral in a grungy way. And I think that color lovers will also kind of get their kick out of it. I will link the 5 looks video that I did down below. Go check it out. And you can use my code if you want to. I also have a code with 5050 makeup. All my codes will be listed down in the description box. Now, the next palette, I actually don't know if I mentioned it last year. Because I actually don't know if I had it last year. But still, I'm going to mention it right now. So maybe it should have been earlier. But it is not. It's the Midas Volume 2. Do I need to say more? Why this is giving me autumny vibes. And honestly, give me a mustard yellow, give me an olive green and I am sold. But it is also what I want to play with right now. It's really, really what I'm into right now. So yeah, also this is again almost a neutral color story for me. And it's so, so stunning. Quality is very, very good. Yes, I am going to go next to one of my favorite brands and that is Odin's Eye Cosmetics. And I have 2 palettes from Odin's Eye Cosmetics in this video. The first one that I pulled is the Big Saga of Freya. And then while I really like this side as well, and that's more of the, yeah, the berry side, you know, the side that's really, really interesting me right now, it's this side. This, especially the maybe it's the combination between that very, very dark brown and then that brighter orange. That is really my vibe right now. And the quality is very, very good. This was actually my first PR from Odin's Eye Cosmetics. And oh, the next palette is a newer palette in their collection. As I'm filming this, it is from their latest collaboration with 3 amazing creators here on YouTube. I have done a video with all the palettes also, by the way. And it is the palette that they did in collaboration with Judy. Now, the other 2 palettes that I have as well, I don't know, Tina's palette for me is more summer vibe. And Annette's palette is more wintery. Maybe even Halloween-y, but a little bit more wintry vibe. This though, I said it in the video that this is the Sweet Talk palette, but then amped up. And because this is a little bit more, I almost want to say, I don't really want to say saturated, but the colors are, well, the Sweet Talk palette for me is more of a happier, it's the wrong way to describe it, but more of a springtime palette. This for me can go both ways. I don't know, the Sweet Talk palette for me, it is more of a springtime palette. And now I really do like it, but this, because here the colors are a little bit more, it's not really muted, but maybe it is, less best, I don't know. But this is, and the quality, oh, it looks like a pretty soft color story, right? Go watch my video, because honestly, I'm doing a look there. And I love that they put in the pops of green. I'm going to show you the shade Luna, because the shade Luna, it has a peach, it has a green, it has a, on camera it kind of has a hot pink as well. All the palettes in this collection, and I have said that on, I've said it actually on numerous occasions, I think that this collection that Odens I did with the three amazing creators, I think it's their best one yet, quality wise. Honestly, I think there are different finishes in here, and can we just appreciate the artwork as well? Now I will link Judy's channel down below. I found her through this collab. Go check her out. She is amazing. She lives in New Zealand, and her whole vibe, she's just... Just go watch her. Go watch her. Go subscribe her. Tell her I sent you. The next palette that I'm going to mention... Yeah, it's this one. Okay. It's the Be Perfect Carnival, the Antidote palette. And this one as well is very, very not Halloween-y, not specifically just autumn for me, because there are also colors in here that make it a little bit more bright that I want to pull in more during the summer. But still, overall, I feel that this is also a very much a nice, toasty, Halloween-y colors. No, what? I'm in a Halloween-y mode. Can you tell? Autumn-y color story. Yes, you can pull it in for Halloween as well. It's Miss Muffet. I think that's it. Miss Muffet is making me go into Halloween-y mode. And also, we are already planning kind of a Halloween-y thing here in the neighborhood. That's where kind of half of my mind is. So, what can I say? I have three palettes left. They are all from the same brand. And it's basically a drugstore brand. The first palette that I'm going to show you is a palette that I have said this before when it launched. It makes me think of, it still makes me think of summer a little bit. So late summer, early fall, but more the nights that are still a little bit warm, maybe that can still happen in fall, but it's just, yeah, it's not really a summer, it's kind of on the cusp of summer and autumn. And it's this one, the Optimistic AF from BH Cosmetics. This is, oh, it looks very, very bright on camera, the yellow. This is, as I said, a little bit on the border, for me at least. So it is too toasty. Too toasty for high summer, unless it's the evening, and it is maybe not toasty enough just yet to be more into autumn, but still this, basically the time of year that we are in now, the leaves are turning, some of the leaves are starting to fall, but it is still, we can still get warm days here. That's basically what this palette represents, and the quality. Oh no, they're not from the same brand. So the never mind. The next palette that I'm going to mention, it's basically the most crunchy that I have here, because I do find myself wanting to do more, I almost want to say emo bitchy looks. Yeah, what can I say? It's this one, the F Off, and I'm not going to name the name of the palette because YouTube is prudish. I'm not, but YouTube is. So this is the color story, and this basically more darker grunginess is what I want to play with when we are going towards more of the darker side of the year. So still fall, but maybe also a little bit more winter, but in the depths, when it's darkness.
Darkness reigns, here I come, hear me roar.
I don't know, but you know, it goes very well with my very nice velvety jacket, by the way. Oh, if you want, I got this in a thrift store. I don't know where it's from. I don't know. That's it. But I really do like it. Then the last palette that I'm going to mention is a palette that I think they are bringing it back. Yes, it's also a palette that released this year, and this can go for a variety of seasons, but I'm going to pull it in now. It's the Wilderness palette from BH Cosmetics. Now, I am going to give a huge congratulations to my friend Angelica, because she's on the Beauty Bay site wearing her look with the Wilderness palette. So I think, and also because when I was on Beauty Bay, to link this palette a few times, actually, it was still on the site, but it said out of stock. So that's why I think that they are going to bring it back. At least for one more round, they should, because I know that a lot of people really, really like this palette. The color story is just such a unique color story. It can go for spring. Yes, it can. But and it can also go for summer a little bit more with these two rows. But for me, I don't know, when I open up this palette here, this is where my mind goes. Did I do 5 looks with this? I think I did. The quality is so, so nice. But it's just, this is what I want to play with right now. Again, I do really think that they are going to bring it back. Maybe they have already restocked it when you are seeing this. I will link where you can find everything down below. So this was it, guys. Let me know some of your fall favorites. Do you even have fall favorites right now? Do you have a specific color story that you are drawn to? Also though, I know that I have people from all over the world, and I know that there's another half of the world that is going to go into spring right now. Let me know some of your favorites then. Yes, and if you've made it this far, leave me the autumn leaf emoji or an orange heart or a green heart or an olive, something like that. Thank you so, so much for watching. If you like the video, give it a thumbs up. If you have any questions or comments, please leave them down in the comment section below. I'm going to wish you a fantastic day, a fabulous evening. May your foundation always match your neck, and I will see you very soon in my next one. Bye guys.